Good morning, students. Welcome once again to online video class from PCHSS Barikota. So, in the last class, I had explained you about test cross, back cross, and incomplete dominance. Now, some what parts are left from the chapters of principles of inheritance and variations. That topics are complementary gene and supplementary gene. What about complementary gene and supplementary genes? Okay. Now, before knowing about complementary gene, first we have to know what the definition is. What? Okay. Complementary gene. Complementary gene. What is called complementary gene? Okay. Two independent pairs of gene interact to produce a new individual where each dominant gene does not express itself. As I wrote the definitions, now you will be very troubled to know what the definition is about. There is a lot of confusion in it. So two independent pairs of genes interact to produce a new individual where each dominant gene does not express itself. What is the definition? What is the particular point is it about? So, without crossing, you can't be able to understand what the definition. Okay? So what the definition is given. Now, the best examples of a complementary gene is example Lathyrus odoratus. So Lathyrus odoratus, it is a scientific name of sweet pea. In these particular plants, so I have to take a genotype and phenotypic. So genotype and phenotype characters. Now, how? Showing you now here. Here is the cross. There is a parents of sweet pea. First you have to mention phenotype, then genotype. Okay, phenotype. What you have to write in phenotype? white flower. What happens when white flower plant crossed with white flower plant? What happens when white flower plant crossed with white flower plants of which plant? That is Lathyrus odoratus, that is sweet pea. Genotype will be okay. So these are the genotype. Capital C and small e, and small c and capital E. Why capital C and small e? Because capital C is representing what? Capital C is raw materials and small e is enzymes. Here raw material is dominating over what? No, here raw material is dominating over enzymes. So capital C is dominating over small e and capital C is dominating over small e. Now both capital C are homozygous and small e both are homozygous, but these are what? No, homozygous capital C and small e homozygous. This is dominant and this is what? No, recessive. But in this case, small c are recessive and capital E is what? No, dominant. Because in capital C there is lack of raw materials, whereas the enzyme is abundant in this particular plant, causing which kind of flower? White color of flower. Okay. Now the gametes. Capital C, small e, and here small c, capital E. Okay, capital C, small e, and capital and small c, capital E. Now, what happens in a cross? These are the gametes. Now, in F1 generation, what happens in F1 generation? What happens in F1 generation? Now, F1 generation, capital C, small c, capital E, small e. Now, again, capital C, capital E, small e. Now, here, small c, capital E, small e. Okay? Next. Small c, capital E, small e. Okay? Now, here, capital C is dominating over small c and capital E is dominating over small e. And here, capital C is dominating over small c and capital E is dominating over small c, e. And here, capital C is dominating over small c and capital E is dominating over small e, and capital C again is dominating over the capital C is dominating over small c, and capital E is dominating over small e. Now in F1 generation, all the colors are what? No, capital C is dominating over small c and capital E is dominating over small e. All the flowers are purple color. Which color? Purple color. As in Mendelian cross, when there is a Mendelian cross, there it is exhibiting which kind of character? That is dominant character. But here neither of the dominant character is exhibiting here. Here it is forming what? No? It is merging with each other. Okay? Now white flower plant and white flower plant, whenever that cross is taking place in the first village generations, all the genotype will be what? No? Purple, and the genotype is what? No? Capital C small c and capital E small e in the first village generations. Okay? Next. So in the first village generation, all the flowers are purple color. Okay? Now what happens in the F2 generations? Now showing you now F2 generation. What happens in F2 generation? F2 generation, that is test cross. We have to test cross. Okay? Now capital C capital C small c capital E small e and capital C small c and capital E small e. Purple into purple. Purple into purple. Okay? Purple flower plant cross with purple color flower plants. Now here capital C, small c, now the gametes are capital C, capital E, now capital C, small c, capital E, and small e. Again here capital C, small c, capital E, small c, small e. Now what happens in the next generation of F2? Capital C, small e, small c, small e. Next, Capital C, small c, small e, small e. Now small c, capital E, small e. Now small c, small c, small e, small e. Okay? Now here, what would be the phenotype in this place? Capital C, capital E, it is purple color flower. Which color flower? Purple. Next is also purple. Why purple? Because capital C both are dominant and here is also dominant character is there, purple. And this one will also what? No, purple. And this one will also purple. Next, capital C, capital C, capital E, small e. It is also purple. And this one, white. Which color flower? White color flower. Because it is showing what? No, parental character, capital C is there. Capital C and small e, it is in the parental character having what? No, white color. The capital C, capital E, small e, purple. Purple. Next, look at here. Now you have to look this compartment now. Capital C, small c and small e. Now capital C, here capital C. You might have put the phenotype here. Phenotype would be what? A purple. But instead of purple, it would be what? No, white. Why white? Because in the definition, as I mentioned you earlier, that in case of complementary genes, two independent pair of genes interact to produce a new trait where each of the dominant gene does not express itself. But here, each of the only one dominant gene is there, but each dominant gene is unable to express itself. So this one will be what? No, white. Why white? Because capital C is there, only one dominant character gene is there, but that dominant character gene is not expressing itself. So that's why it will be what? No, why? Why? Okay? Now, capital C, small c, capital E, purple. Again, this is the parental character, small c, capital E, parental character, so it will be what? No, why? Now, small c, capital E, small e. Again, this one white. Why? Because instead of purple, white I am mentioning here. Because as in the definition complementary gene, two independent pair of genes interact to produce a new trait where each of the dominant gene does not express itself. Because capital E is a dominant gene, but it is not expressing by itself. So that's why it is white. Next, capital C, capital E, small e, purple. Capital C, small e, it will be white. Only one dominant gene is there, but it is instead of one dominant gene, in spite of presenting of dominant gene capital C, it is not produced, it is not expressing by itself. So instead of purple, here it would be the phenotype of white. No? White. Next, small c, capital E, small e, white. And this is also white. None of the genes are dominating. So that's why it is white. So what is the ratio in the complementary gene? Purple. How many purple are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 purple are there and white? 7 white is there. 9 is to 7. What is the ratio of complementary gene in gene when a Lathyrus moderatus of white flower plant is crossed with another white flower plant in the ratio of the F2 generation, it would be what? No, 9 is to 7. So 9 is purple and 7 is what? No, white. Okay? Generally, in the dihybrid cross, 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1 is mentioned, but in case of complementary gene, it is showing 9 is to 7. So this is called what? No, complementary gene. So the definitions of the complementary gene, that is two independent pair of gene interact to produce a new individual where each dominant gene does not express itself. As I mentioned here, because one dominant gene cannot express itself to produce purple color. Instead of purple, it is producing what? No, white color flower. Okay? Now, complementary gene is over. Next is supplementary gene. Supplementary gene. Now, in supplementary gene, the exact definition of supplementary gene is two independent pair of genes, two इंडिपेंडेंट पेयर ऑफ जीन्स इंटरैक्ट टू प्रोड्यूस अ न्यू इंडिविजुअल where each dominant gene can express itself, okay? In complementary gene, so each dominant gene does not express itself, but in case of supplementary gene, each of the dominant gene can express itself. So this is the difference between complementary and supplementary gene. But in case of complementary gene, the ratio between the purple and white, the white was 9:7. In supplementary gene, again I am dictating that is two independent pair of genes interact to produce a new individual where each dominant gene cannot, so each dominant gene can express itself. Okay? Supplementary gene. The best examples to check for the supplementary gene is rooster, the cross between rooster and hen. Okay? So which kind of rooster I have, so which kind of rooster you have to cross between the hen or hen? So I am showing you the some important breeds of the roosters and the hen where the supplementary gene is obeying. Okay, first this is the diagram of it. So this is the structure of it. This is the comb. What it is called? It is called what? No, comb. This is the breed of which chicken? This is the breed of Wyandotte. Okay, having which kind of comb? This is called which kind of comb? Rose comb. Which comb? Rose comb. Okay. Another one. This is walnut. Walnut comb. Which kind of comb? Walnut comb. Which kind of comb? Walnut. Okay. Next. Number one. Number two. Rose comb. Now pea comb. This is the structure of a pea comb. Inside the pea comb, three ridges are there. These are the ridges. Okay, these are the ridges forming a comb. Of which comb? This is a which kind of comb? Pea comb. Which kind of comb? Pea comb. And this breed of the chicken name is Brahma. Next, number four. Sorry, number four. And this is number three. And this is number four. This is called a single comb. Which kind of comb? Single comb. Single comb. Okay? There is a single comb. And this breed, and the name of the breed of this chicken is white leg horn. White leg horn. White leg horn. Okay? Now, so three breed of chickens are there. One is Wyandotte and Brahma. And this is what? Leg horn. Leg horn. Okay? Wyandotte having which kind of comb? That is called a rose comb. And Brahma having which kind of comb? Pea comb. And this is the walnut. And walnut is the what, the intermediate character between the rose comb and pea comb. Whenever there is a cross between the pea comb and rose comb, and the intermediate character which is showing between the cross between pea comb and rose comb, the intermediate character is what, the walnut. And this is what, the white leg horn is recessive character. Which character? Recessive chicken. Okay. Now I am showing you the cross between the pea comb and rose comb to find out the supplementary gene. Because writing the definition is not enough to understand. So to understand appropriately, you have to make a cross between what, the pea comb and rose comb. So I am showing you here. manganese. Henotype, genotype, phenotype, PCOM, cross between PCOM and ROSCOM, ROSCOM. Okay, this is the male and this is female. PCOM and ROSCOM, genotype, capital P, small r, small r. Okay, because capital P representing PCOM. Okay, next. ROSCOM, capital R, small p, okay? Or you can write it in this way also, small p, capital R, okay? This is what, ROSCOM, which kind, which kind of com? This is ROSCOM and this is what, PCOM. Now, gametes, what the gametes should be there? Capital P, small r, and here, small p, capital R, and small p, capital R. Now F1 generation. In F1 generation, what the phenotype would be? Capital P, capital R, small r. Again, P, capital R, small r. Now here, P, capital R, small r. Again, P, capital R, small r. In F1 generation, all the progenies which is forming in the F1 generations are showing which kind of character, that is walnut. All are walnut. Okay, all are walnut chicken. Now, when a cross is taking between the PCOM and ROSCOM in the F1 generation, all the progeny which is forming what now? Walnut chicken. Okay, next. In what happens in F2 generation? What happens in F2 generation when there is a cross between the two walnut chicken? When there is a cross between the two walnut chicken, and what would be the phenotypic and genotypic ratio? Now you have to find out. Now, selfing walnut into walnut, capital P, small p, and capital R, smaller. Now the gametes would be capital P, small r, and small p, small r. And here also capital P, small r, and small p, small r. Now, look at here. Capital P, capital R, capital P, small r. Now, capital P, capital R, capital R again. Capital P, capital R, small r. Capital P, small p, capital R. Capital P, small p, capital R, small r. Next, capital P, capital R, small r. Capital P, capital P, small r. Capital P, small p, capital R, small r. Next, capital P, small p, small r. Next, capital P, small p, capital R. Next, capital P, small p, capital R, small r. Next, small p, capital R, capital R. Now, small p, capital R, small r. Capital P is there, small p, capital R, small r. Small, so capital P, small p, small r, small r. Next, small p, capital R, small r. Small p, small r, small r. Now, what would be here then? Capital P is there. It would be capital P, capital R. It would be one nut. Because no parental character is showing here. Because in the parental character, in case of P, capital P, smaller was there. But in case of rose com, small p, capital R, capital R was there. Okay, now capital P and capital R representing walnut. This is also what? No, walnut. Because in walnut, capital P is dominating over small p and capital R was dominating over small r. So that's why capital P and capital R indicating what? If there is a presence of capital P and capital R, then there would be, and then the character could be possessing which kind? Walnut. Next, capital P, so capital P, small p, capital R, this is also walnut. Next, capital P, capital R, smaller, walnut. Capital P, smaller, p-com. Which kind of com? P-com. Small p, capital R, smaller, it would be what? No, p-com. Okay, next. No, not p-com, it would be rose. It is supplementary. Which kind of gene? Supplementary gene. Because capital P, small p. Now capital P and small p and capital R smaller. It would be walnut, not p, walnut. Because capital P, small p and capital R smaller, walnut. Next, capital P, small r. So what would be here then in case of supplementary gene? As I mentioned you earlier that in supplementary gene, two independent pair of genes interact to produce a new individual where each dominant gene can express itself. Because capital P is there, only one dominant gene is there. So here it can express by itself. So what the character also, what the character of the phenotype would be here then? P. Because capital P is dominating over small p and smaller is there. In case of supplementary gene, each dominant gene can express itself. So it would be what? No, P. Next. Capital P, capital R, walnut. Next, capital P, capital R, smaller. This is also walnut. Now, small p, capital R. It is a parental character. It would be what? Rose. Next, small p, capital R, smaller, capital R. So this is one of supplementary gene because it is rose com. Which kind of com? Rose com. Okay. Next, capital P, capital R, smaller, walnut. Walnut. Next, small p, small r, smaller. Here would be p because it is showing what? A supplementary gene. Why? In supplementary gene, only one dominant gene can express itself. Next, this is also rose com. Why rose com? Because capital R, only one dominant gene is expressing by itself. It would be what? No, rose. Next one is small p, smaller is there. It would be rose. Sorry, it would be what? Single. It would be what? Single. Only one. So the ratio. Ratio is 9:3:1. 9 walnut, 3 rose comb, 3 pea comb, 1 single. Okay, so this is the cross between the pea comb and rose comb. So what happens in the phenotypic ratio of P com and rose com? So 9 walnut it is producing and 3 rose com and 3 P com and 1 single. Okay? So this representing what? No? Supplementary gene. Why supplementary gene? Because only one dominant gene is expressing by itself. So that's why it is supplementary gene. So the complementary genes and supplementary genes. So what is the difference between complementary and supplementary gene? In case of complementary gene, two independent pairs of genes interact to produce a new individual where each dominant gene does not express itself. So its ratio was 9:7. in complementary gene, which kind of examples I have taken? That is what? No, Lathyrus odoratus. So Lathyrus odoratus, it is sweet pea. Next, in case of supplementary gene, so two independent pair of genes interact to produce a new individual where each dominant gene can express itself. Remember it, can express itself. But the ratio would be what? No, 9:3:3:1, similar to what? No, dihybrid cross. Okay, dihybrid cross in Mendel's. Okay, next. Next is linkage. It is a very lengthy unit. Linkage is a very lengthy unit. So this topic could be continuing on next day. Okay? Linkage is a very important topic. So this topic could be continuing on the next day. Okay? Till then, thank you.